Limited access to credit is a problem in many developing countries, and for entrepreneurs in these markets, an inability to borrow can substantially constrain economic growth. At the same time, a number of studies have shown that marginal returns to capital in this population, in other words, the financial return from an extra dollar of investment, are well above standard interest rates on microcredit loans. This implies that there are profitable lending opportunities available, but for whatever reason, they are not being realized. Now, one potential explanation is that it is difficult for lenders to distinguish between high and low ability entrepreneurs. This informational friction exists in all credit markets, but is especially acute in developing countries where verifiable income information and credit histories are non-existent. For example, a typical loan applicant might operate a small convenience store next to her home, with nothing to distinguish her from the dozen other small shopkeepers in the same neighborhood. In this paper, the authors explore whether lenders can use information embedded in local communities to solve this problem. Ex ante, it's unclear whether this should help or hinder lenders' efforts to target high-return entrepreneurs. On the one hand, neighbors and acquaintances may be better informed about traits that are difficult for lenders to observe, such as an entrepreneur's diligence, perseverance, and business acumen. On the other hand, community members may not have a good understanding of what constitutes entrepreneurial ability, and even if they did, they may distort their predictions in favor of friends and family if they are aware that their input will influence who receives a loan and who doesn't. To shed light on these questions, the authors conducted a randomized controlled trial with 1,345 entrepreneurs and their neighbors in Amravati, India. After administering a baseline survey, entrepreneurs were divided into groups of 4 to 6 based on geographic proximity and asked to rank themselves and their group members on several characteristics, including total value of household assets, average monthly income over the past year, projected monthly profits, and predicted marginal return to capital. For the latter, respondents were asked, of the entrepreneurs in their group, who could grow their profits the most if they were to receive a grant of 6,000 rupees, or roughly $100? This is a shock equivalent to 1.5 months of profits for the median business in this sample. In order to determine whether community members distort their rankings when there are financial incentives at play, half of the participants were told that their reports would only be used for research purposes, call this the no-stakes treatment, while the other half were told that their reports would be used to allocate grants to members of the community, call this the real-stakes treatment. Once the community reports were complete, the researchers conducted a lottery and allocated grants to 1/3 of the entrepreneurs in the sample. Those who had been ranked highly by their peers in the real stakes treatment were provided with extra lottery tickets to increase their chances of winning. The results of this experiment show first that community members can identify high-ability entrepreneurs with remarkable accuracy. This figure shows log profits measured after the completion of the experiment, plotted against the marginal returns ranking given to each entrepreneur by their group members. Looking separately at lottery winners and losers, we see that marginal returns rank is positively correlated with the level of profits in both groups. The key, however, lies in the gap between these two lines. This measures marginal profits. In other words, the increase in profits that results from randomly receiving a grant as a result of the study. And we see that this gap is wider for those with higher marginal returns rank. Put another way, community rankings are highly predictive of actual marginal returns to capital. In terms of magnitudes, while the average marginal return to the grant was about 8% per month, entrepreneurs ranked in the top third of the community earned monthly returns between 17 and 27%. A back-of-the-envelope calculation suggests that had the researchers required entrepreneurs to repay their grant with a 26% APR, which is the regulatory cap on interest rates in India, all entrepreneurs above the 58th percentile of the rank's distribution would have earned a net positive return on their investment. Interestingly, the authors also show that these community rankings capture information over and above what even the best informed lender could glean from observable information. Using the rich set of household and business characteristics collected as part of their baseline survey, The authors use a machine learning algorithm to identify the combination of observable characteristics that is the best predictor of marginal returns. They then show that even after controlling for these, there remains additional predictive power contained in the community rankings. So far, the results suggest that lending institutions could substantially improve their ability to identify and target high-return entrepreneurs by leveraging community information. But a potential obstacle is that community members may distort their information if they know it will influence lending decisions. And indeed, the authors show that community rankings collected in the real stakes treatment are less accurate than those collected in the no stakes treatment. When there is an incentive to behave strategically, survey respondents become more likely to rank themselves and their family members more highly, and this leads to a 34.6% decline in accuracy as measured by ex post returns. However, the authors argue that it is possible to implement simple interventions to realign incentives and induce truthful reporting. While forcing community members to report their rankings in public rather than in private appears to have limited effect, providing small monetary payments to reward accuracy does reduce distortion. In conclusion, this paper argues that community members have valuable information about their peers that can be truthfully elicited and used to target loans to high-return entrepreneurs. Credit constraints constitute a major impediment to economic growth in many developing countries, and this paper's findings suggest that it may be possible for banks, governments, and nonprofit institutions to alleviate these constraints by tapping into the wealth of knowledge contained in local communities and social networks. To delve deeper into this topic, you can check out the full paper and its references to other related research. These include papers on micro-entrepreneurs in developing countries, a mechanism design literature on how to extract and use peer information, and papers studying other contexts in which community information can help private and public sector actors overcome information asymmetries.